Yeah, sorry, my previous video cut off, but yeah, so what I'm saying is that why do Americans, Europeans care how many years the president is in power? Because if it's a good person, if it's in power for the rest of his life, he will be good. And if it's a bad president, then he can screw the country up in 4 years. So why does it matter? I don't even understand. To me, they're just fucking retarded, you know? Shit. So I think it's not fair for this guy that Americans and Europeans are treating him that way, and that kind of pissed me off. Like I said, in my opinion, American president should only care about America and its citizens. I know I'm included in that because I have a dual citizenship, both Russian and American, so even though I may not have a standard opinions because I was born and raised in Russia, but because I pretty much lived almost 10 years in the United States, and it's only required 5 years to live in the United States in order to become a citizen. So even though I have a Russian mindset, I'm still an American citizen. And even though I don't have American mentality or American views on life, I'm still an American citizen. Therefore, when I'm in America, I'm a subject to act an American, and I'm a subject, you know, to be treated like American no matter what. But as far as I'm not in the United States, I believe American president or anybody who is from that country should not influence me in any way, in any shape or form. You know? And I don't like how these American people, they're dictating other people who are not Americans how to live and telling them to live like they do. I really don't like it. I really don't agree with it personally. And I think, you know, that countries like Uganda or Russia or other countries, they should just figure out the way how to do what they want to do, how to live their own way, and to be not less successful than Americans or Europeans. Because it's kind of dependence, you know, it's not cool that they're like enslaved by Americans. But this is different kind of slavery, different kind of relationship, dictatorship. In this part of dictatorship, America is basically saying, you know what? They're basically saying, you know what? Here's the money, we're gonna help you if you do the right thing. And if you don't, we're not giving you money and we're not gonna sell you anything, so fuck you. So people just need to figure out the way and how, like, to make happen that they can just do everything by themselves and live by themselves and not to be dependent on more developed countries like European, on more developed countries, not be developed on like UK or America. So that way European Union or America not gonna give them no bullshit as sanctions or none of that. So that's the goal for all the developing countries or third world countries, in my opinion. Because that pisses me off how America ruins everybody's lives because they don't act American. That's not a free world. That's not. That's an American dictatorship, like Muammar Gaddafi said. And I agree with him on that. It is. And America should stop dictating everybody else and telling everybody else how they need to live. Okay? They should just focus on themselves and cut all the foreign aids to everybody and just say, we Americans, we only care about our citizens and fuck everyone else. That's how Americans should live. And that way they will live better. And they're not gonna bother everybody else who don't wanna live their way anyway. I also did some tests. And whether I'm Republican or Democrat, I got 50-50 that I just have my own ways. And when I did, like, am I liberal or conservative? I got 57% conservatives and 43% liberal. So I'm a moderate conservative. Which works well for me, you know. Because when I thought about it, you know, to be absolutely conservative, you know, that's kind of not right. Because, you know, sometimes you can be strict on certain things. and then it can be not right. For example, like when it comes to poor and taxes, you may think that rich people, you know, should pay less taxes because they can be good for economy. But then again, what if the rich person pays less, pockets his money, and he doesn't support anybody? He's like selfish man. And he will have all the money, and everybody is gonna suck a dick. And that's not really cool, you know. Because rich people not necessarily gonna support businesses. But on the other hand, immigration, for example, if you're gonna allow everybody and let everybody come to America, all these people who don't have American mentality, who don't want to live like American people, who want to do things like they want to do it, they can be a detriment for the country because they're gonna piss people off, they're gonna take jobs from American people, they're gonna be bad for economy, all of that, they're gonna be, you know, they're gonna be like a parasites, you know, and people not gonna like them. And like I said, I think that all this mentality that, you know, you can be anything, can do any, and every all the people are equal, this is all illusion, that's not true. Because if that would be the case, then there would be no mentality, it would be just a chaos. And country of chaos, which is multiculturalism, what it is, it's really a chaos. If America would be truly multicultural country, that wouldn't be a strong country, it would be a chaotic country, which would be already broken. So, massive immigration is not good. Only immigrants who work hard to stay should be there. Everybody else should just go back, should be sent out. You know, illegals should be sent out. So that's why, like, you know, I'm kind of moderate conservative. Like, I'm not, like, very strong, but... I'm on the conservative side of spectrum. That's just my personal opinion. So that's what I've been doing, and everything else, I've just been walking around with my mom and thinking about things, reading things. It's interesting stuff, you know? Interesting stuff. Enjoy Helsinki, you know, it's a good place to be in, but it's too damn cold and too damn expensive. These are the two minuses, but rather than that, it's a beautiful place. It is clean, nice, beautiful. People are here walking around, which I don't like. Hopefully they're not gonna complain about my weird behavior in here, but I just have nowhere else to go. I don't want to do this video in front of my mom. I just don't feel it. That's right. So. But this beer, nobody asked me for my ID. I'm like, thank God. That's another thing in America should be changed. If fucking 30-year-old man goes to the store, why he should get carded? You can tell that 30-year-old man not gonna look like he's 21.